What's up, everyone? My name is Dora, and you're watching Creative Bath Lab. Today, we're talking about emulsifying waxes, also known as e-waxes, which are comprised of waxy flakes or pellets. Emulsifiers are crucial for recipes that combine oil and water, like lotion. They mix the oil and water together permanently, creating a stable mixture known as an emulsion. Note, even though they're made out of wax material and have the word wax right there in their name, they don't behave anything like real waxes, like beeswax or Candelilla wax, and such cannot be substituted for one another. Emulsifiers vary in many different ways. They each impart different feels, consistencies, and viscosities. Today, I'll mainly be focusing on their thickening abilities. I experimented with 10 different emulsifiers and got everything from super thick to water thin with everything in between. I'm sharing the results with you so that you can choose the perfect emulsifier for your next formulation. It is so important to know which viscosity best suits your project. This can save you hours of experimenting. Super thick emulsions are ideal for whipped formulations like whipped soap, whipped body butter, or whipped body scrub. Stay tuned in to find out how to make the thickest emulsion possible. Thick emulsions are ideal for rich, dense formulations like face and hair masks, hand cream, or body scrubs. Medium to thick emulsions are ideal for thicker liquids like lotion, face cream, shampoo, or conditioner. Medium to thin emulsions are ideal for medium viscosity liquids like hand soap, body wash, or bubble bath. And thin emulsions are ideal for really thin, fluid liquids like sprays, like lotion sprays, liquid for foaming pumps, or liquid cleansers. I use the same recipe for each emulsion. Heat the emulsifying wax with any oil or butter until the wax and butter is melted. Heat the water separately to roughly the same temperature. Now combine the two heated phases with a stick blender. As the emulsion cools, it thickens. Wait until it's fully cool to determine the final consistency. The results are in order from thickest to thinnest. Emulsifying wax creates a super thick, dense emulsion with stiff peaks. There's no movement and it doesn't drop from the spoon. Fontanove 68 is essentially the same as emulsifying wax. It creates a super thick, dense emulsion with stiff peaks and little to no movement. Kim Conks is essentially the same as the first two, except it's a bit silkier. BTMS 25% creates a very thick emulsion with stiff peaks, but it's not as dense. It's a bit fluffier and a bit lighter. It has a little bit of movement, unlike the first three. It will drop from the spoon very slowly. I think it's just an absolutely beautiful emulsion. Glycerol stearate creates a medium to thick emulsion. It's gorgeous. It's so silky and smooth. It plops when it's dropped by the spoon. Cetearyl alcohol creates a medium to thick emulsion. It plops or pours very slowly. It pours a little more freely than the one before. Cetyl alcohol creates a medium to thin emulsion. It pours more readily when dropped by a spoon. Glycerol stearate and PEG 100 creates a thin emulsion that can easily be poured. Stearic acid was really weird. It didn't emulsify well as the emulsion separated. You can clearly see the really thick oil on top and the thin liquid on bottom. So I wouldn't use it as a primary emulsifier. It didn't thicken well either. The really thick part was on top, but once the emulsion was stirred, it was fluid like water. Stearic acid is a wonderful ingredient, especially as a hardener, but I wouldn't use it as a primary emulsifier or thickener. Perhaps as a secondary emulsifier and thickener. Cetearyl 20 is similar to stearic acid. It didn't emulsify, the emulsion separated, oil on top, water on bottom, and it also didn't thicken. Once stirred, the emulsion is fluid like water. Cetearyl 20 can do wonderful things, but it's just not right for this job. For thicker emulsions, use a hard butter instead of oil. For even thicker emulsions, increase the butter and decrease the water. You can actually get it even thicker than this.
So I left this in there like overnight and like, wow, look at this. It can be smushed, but like that is super thick.
Just in case you were wondering, you can use e-waxes in surfactant-based formulas, like body wash. I use the exact same recipe as before with emulsifying wax, but instead of using water, I added body wash. Okay, so while it doesn't make sense to add an emulsifier to an oil-based formula that doesn't contain water, I was curious to see if it would thicken. And it did. This is 50 grams of liquid carrier oil and 10 grams of emulsifying wax. Once it cools enough, the oil thickens nicely. Normally, I just use a specific butter to get the thickness that I want. However, it is good to know that this is an option. All right, guys, thanks so much for joining me. For more awesome tutorials just like this, subscribe now. Click my face. It's right there in the middle.